Designated is back by popular demand. Getting ready for the Kansas Nationals, the Menards NHRA Nationals here at Heartland Motorsports Park. First pair out, Kevin Leinart. Kevin, you've got a race against Mr. Kramer over there. How are you going to handle it in this battle of Mopars?
Well, he's a very tough customer and he's very good, but I have got to try my best to try and cut a halfway decent light. And I hope I can see him at the finish line so I can touch the brakes a little bit and maybe pull it off. He's going to be tough.
All right, so it sounds like you're going to be leaving first. What's your dialing going to be? And are you going to be dialed honest? Are you going to be holding some? What's your strategy?
We always dial real hard and real honest, and we're going to probably be dialed 1330.
All right, how have your reaction times been this weekend?
Not so good. I went red on the first Q1, and I had a bad light on the second, so we're going to have to see what happens.
All right, good luck. Good luck. We'll see you on the top end.
Thank you. You guys have a good day. Thank you very much.
All right, we're here with Russ Kramer, who has actually been on attention in the pits in the past. Now he's on designated. We just spoke with Mr. Leinart. He gave us his strategy. You're going to have to chase him down with your A-automatic. So tell us your race strategy.
Well, I don't know for sure here. I didn't get down the racetrack yesterday.
Which is why you're designated.
That's exactly right. But I have a pretty good idea what the car will run. I was here 2 weeks ago. So we had some experimental carburetors on there yesterday, and we had to go back to the good ones. So I think, hopefully we can get down there, get in front of him, and take as little wind light as possible.
Are you going to be dialed like honest? You gonna hold some? What's your plan?
He knows
that you run it up in Brainerd. He was like, that guy run it up in Brainerd last year.
It's hard with him. Either you gotta hold a whole bunch or you just hold nothing and get right down there.
All right, we'll see you on the top end. Good luck.
Thank you.
So give us a number for your dialing. 10 what?
I don't know. We'll probably 65, 66, somewhere in there maybe.
All right, good luck.
All right, thank you.
13-29 is the dial or the prediction for Kevin Leinart on the left side. Russ Kramer says he's gonna run 10.65. Now, Russ Kramer did not go down the racetrack in qualifying. So he is coming up here dialing blind. The real question is going to be whether they figured out what was wrong with that car. There goes the two barrel. It's like trying to breathe through a straw. Well, there's no question about it. Russ Kramer is going to make his best run of the weekend, but he took a wild stab with the shoe polish and wins it. How about that? 10.68, 113 miles an hour. Kevin Leinart goes 13.29 after he predicted he would run 13.29.
Come over here, Russ. Come over here. Come over here. Come over here. Oh, I got the slip. I got it. He's super happy. All right, he's super happy over here. I was trying to wave you over there so we don't hold him up. What kind of light did you have, Russ? Yeah, that's what this is all about.
I don't know. Probably like 35.
All right, why don't you check out your slip? Tell us, what happened?
Oh, 004, that's way too tight. I should not have been there.
Yeah, and what about your opponent? Check it out, what a great race.
Yeah, close, what are we talking here? I took a little too much stripe, but I was so easy, I got there kind of easily, so I was like, well.
You're 004.3 over, he's 90 dead on, so each of.
He had eye surgery a little while ago, so he's like, probably couldn't find it. His eyes are still getting, his first time out.
Are you taunting him?
No. He just told me in the lanes. Maybe he was just psychologically trying to get me.
Maybe he was. Well, you won the race.
Double almost got me to go red.
There you go. Good luck.
Thank you.
All right, Russ Kramer, he is the winner. Let's go over to Kevin Leinart. Kevin, what do you think your light was?
I hoped it was at least 40 or better.
He had a 004 on you, man. That's tough. You were
004.
Dead on.
Oh, wow. Well, we dialed it right. Just couldn't do good enough on the light. Got to do better next time.
There it is. Good luck. Thank you.
All right. Thank you, guys. Appreciate it.
All right. Jamie Peach in this awesome Buick is going to be battling his F-Automatic. Jamie, what's your dialing going to be?
I'm guessing right now it looks very similar to yesterday morning. To be honest, though, I'm going to make sure I have a couple in the bank because of the wind. The wind for me in this car is always a little bit suspect, so I'll probably have a couple there.
Yeah, I wonder why, right? You have a giant machine.
Yeah, and that's exactly right. The width of this car is very large, and its frontal area is not in my favor. So any kind of headwind hurts me quite a bit more than other cars. So I got to take that into consideration.
You feel like you're going to be leaving first?
I will be leaving first. The guy, my opponent, looks like he's dialed about a 10.75, so I'll have about a 3/10 handicap on him. So I'll have to get down to the end and make some decisions down there.
All right, we'll see you on the top end.
All right, appreciate it. Thank you. Okay.
And we're here with Cecil Bray, who's going to be running Jamie in a battle of, like, amazing muscle cars. Like, this is what it's all about. We just heard his strategy. Tell us about yours.
Well, pretty much, I'm going to run him honest. If it wasn't for him, I wouldn't have got in. He let us know that somebody was getting out of the stock, and we were able to get in, and he called us and let us know. So I'm going to run this guy honest.
But you're not going to take, you're not going to give up the opportunity.
Oh,
to load
no,
up.
I'm sending him home. I'm sending him home.
What's your dialing?
1075.
All right. Good luck. We'll see you on the top.
Yeah, thank you.
And Cecil Bray, talking about cool. 1970 428 Cobra Jet Mustang. So we've got the Iowa-based Mustang. We've got the Minnesota-based Buick GS. Couple of big inch cars from back in the day. There's the handicap, and the two blue machines both get away on a green. Well, our string of 00 light for the win has come to a close. But in this particular matchup, Jamie used an 011 light for the win. Runs 1121, 108 miles an hour. Bray was 042 on the bulb, left a little bit back here, then goes 1083.
All right, Jamie Peached, his F automatic. All right, Jamie. You're smiling. Do you know what happened? Why don't you tell us what you think your light was?
So I'm going to say, I think I missed the tree slightly. I'm going to say about a 40 on the tree. He did tell me he had some problems before the run. Obviously, he wasn't able to make a good run. Gave me some room down here to get out of it and keep things safe.
All right. We're giving him the tree. This guy was. Jeez. Yeah. Oh, jeez. You're like Morty. Jeez. 11 reaction time.
It's a good way to start the day, guys. Thank you very much.
All right. There goes Jamie and his Buick. Let's go talk to Mr. Bray. All right, so the guy got after you on the starting line. Yep. 11, Jamie was good. But you're 42, okay. So not bad, but obviously the car wouldn't run the number. Yep. Tell us about going down the racetrack.
Hey, it was great. It was great. I done my best. It just didn't happen. You know, we'll always be here next time.
I love your attitude. That's what we need in designated. We need people to talk trash.
Any day I wake up and I ain't 6 feet under, I'm in good mood.
I agree. Thank you very much. Appreciate you being on our show.
Hey, thank you.
All right. And that's what's happening here at Kansas. They were designated.